So in this unit, we are going to look at searching and sorting for a value in a list of values. So let's review how lists of values are actually stored in a computer. So there are two basic ways of storing a sequence, as you know, arrays and lists. Now, functionally, they may look similar, but from a complexity theory point of view, from an efficiency point of view, how the data is organized makes a difference. So let's just review some basic ideas about arrays and lists. So an array, to begin with, is a single block of memory. So if you have an array, you should think of it as something which has consecutive elements storing the values in the array. So if we have an array A of size n, then A0 is immediately followed by A1 and so on until An-1. So the crucial fact now is that if I know where the array starts, then if I want to get to some value ai, then I just have to multiply by I the size of each unit of array to find out exactly where ai is. So this amounts to saying that we can access any value ai, any position I in the array in constant time, regardless of whether I is at the beginning or at the end, because we just have to compute the offset, right? So we have the starting position, and then given I, we can compute directly in one shot, just doing arithmetic with respect to the starting address, the position of ai. Now, on the other hand, if I want to insert an element between ai and ai plus 1, this becomes a bit complicated, but because supposing I now want to push a value here, that means I have to take these values, right, and move them down. That means each of these values has to be shifted by one. Therefore, the time taken to insert an element depends on the position, but in the worst case, I might have to shift all the elements by one. So this could take time proportional to the size of the array. So this could be an order n of operations. The same way, contraction can require me to take an array, and then if I want to remove this element, then I have to shift all of these elements up by one. So if I want to expand or contract an array, it's an expensive operation, but I can access any given element in an array in a fixed cost time, which is independent of the position, and I can just treat it as like any other access, like accessing a variable x or y or anything else simple in my program. A list, on the other hand, is generally a flexible structure, and as elements are added, they get scattered around the memory with no fixed relationship to each other. So typically, a list will have values in different parts of the memory, and the idea is that each value will point, so supposing this is the beginning of the list, right, then this will point to the next element, this will point to the third element, this will point to the fourth element, and so on, right? So because of this linking structure, usually in most introductory data structures courses, lists are often referred to as linked lists. So a linked list is just a concrete way of implementing such a flexible structure. So now what this means is that if I want to find where, say, L2 is, so let's assume that this is L0, L1, and L2, okay, then I have no idea in general where L2 is located, but I know where L0 is located because my list name in my program L will point to L0. So I'll have to follow these arrows until I reach L2. Right? So in general, if I want to go to LAI, I have to start at A0, then follow my link to A1, and so on. So this will take me I steps. So therefore, the further down in a list I need to go, the longer it takes me. So accessing AI is proportional to I. So in general, if I have to access the ith element of a list, it's a linear time operation. On the other hand, inserting and deleting is comparatively easy. If I know where I am, supposing I want to insert something between L2 and L3, then what I would do is I would first construct a new node here. Okay, and then I will do what I would call plumbing. So I will remove this link and I would instead insert a link from L2 to the new node and from the new node to L3. And I know which links to add because this is a node I've just created, so I know its location. And L2 points to L3, so I can transfer that information to the new node so that these links can be established. Okay? And a similar thing happens when I want to delete a node. If I want to delete this node, for example, right, then what I have to do is I just take this link and I bypass it and go directly here, right? So by just shuffling these links around in a local sense, in a constant amount of time, you can insert or delete at any point in a list. But finding a position requires me to start at the beginning and go to the end, which takes linear time. So this distinction has an impact on what we can do. Suppose we want to take a sequence of values, right? And we want to take a value at position I and position j, and I want to exchange them. So if I know the positions I and j. In an array, I can easily get to ai and aj in constant time and exchange them. So this is exactly like swapping x and y. Okay, there's no difference between swapping x and y and swapping ai and aj. But if it is a list, then I have to walk down to find this, then I have to walk down to find that. So I have to find these two things and then I have to exchange. So it will take me linear time just to locate the positions to exchange. On the other hand, as we have already seen, if we wanted to delete an element from the middle of a list, or we want to insert an element into a list, this takes constant time, provided we are already at AI. So if we reach AI and we find at this position we want to do something, we can do that operation, insertion or deletion, in constant time. But at that position, if we want to insert a value or contract the array, then we have to shift a whole number of elements forwards or backwards, and this will take linear time. So sometimes this impacts what we can do, and algorithms that work well in one data structure will not work in the other, though they are abstractly representing the same thing, a sequence of values from 1 to n or 0 to n minus 1. As an example of this, we will see soon binary search. Binary search works on arrays but does not work on lists because it requires us to repeatedly probe the array at some index I in an efficient way.